Last week was a sad one if you're a fan of soul music. Bobby Womack and Teeny Hodges passed away. Two of my five favorite guitar players, Al Green and Teeny Hodges, wrote a bunch of great tunes together. One of them being Take Me to the River. And I'll show you the chords in this tune. I want to focus on what happens in the E chord. The song is in the key of E. And it involves a droning bottom string and an upchuck on the three strings at the bottom, one of them fretted. I'm fretting an E at the nut. And watch the right hand. I also want to focus on the slide that he does throughout the song. You'll see. This is easy to do. You got to mute it so it doesn't ring out. So you hit it and then you're muting it with your palm. What I'm talking about. The slide happens from the fretted G sharp note on the G string. It slides up to the 12th, 13th fret territory. Not the whole chord, just the note. And that happens on the offbeat between the third and fourth beat of the measure. Here's how you count that. And one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three. Right. The downbeat is the one, two, three, four. The beat in between the same length of the same length note is the and. It's vocalized and. You could be into one and a two and a three, but this is just one and two and three and four. So on the and, three and, that's where the slide. Got it? Yeah, but you didn't know I used to be a professor at the Berklee School of Music, Chester, West Virginia branch campus. Anyway, so Al Green starts singing on the first verse. And there's a D chord at the nut, and the A chord is staccato A played here. Then it goes back to the E, and that E is always played with the drone and the... like that. A, and that sounds like this. The A is three notes. It hits the chorus from the D, and that's a C, three notes, with the F note as a suspension, the G with the E note as a suspension, this D chord, three notes, with the G note as a suspension, and then an A7. You've got to have that G note in there. You could play an A7 with the, you want the sound of the G note, and that's this. Next verse, instead of the A being staccato up here, it's played at the nut, the A chord I'm talking about, at the nut, like this. next is the bridge, and that's a C sharp minor. And add, don't play the bottom two strings. The C sharp minor, add and subtract the B note, excuse me, the B note on the 12th fret, and you'll see. And then don't play the bottom two strings for the A chord, and add the F sharp note as a suspension. That's followed by a G, and you can even get the E note in there, you'll see. And then a B7. When does he do that slide? Pretty much every other time, especially at this point. And by every other time, I'll count it for you. That's what I'm talking about. One and two and three and four and one and two and three. One and two and three and four and one and two and three. And one and two and three and four and one and two and three. Yeah, every other time. More, I hate to be using the word late to describe Teddy Hodges, but it's pretty amazing when you can deservedly have great put before your name. So, I miss you, the late, great Teddy Hodges. Thanks for watching.